let's take a bit of time to go through our setup. So the way that we can get to setup is hitting displays, and you'll notice that there is either a setup soft key that you can hop in with, or there's setup in the browser menu. So for now, I'm just gonna hit my setup button, and I will go into my EO settings. The setup area is broken into three main areas, and this is particularly important when you're dealing with multiple devices on the same network. System settings will affect every user and how the show functions. User settings will allow you to pick specific things for individual users, and device settings let you change things on a device-by-device basis. I'm just gonna take you through a couple of quick highlights of the system. Don't forget that your manual and your help system are great ways to learn about the other features that we won't cover. In the main system area, the number of channels defaults to 5,000. If you're not using that many channels, you can change that to a lower number, and that'll help you not have to page through all the excess channels. If we go into our queue settings area, one of the great things that you can change is your queue default times. So when you record a new queue, if you don't give it a time, it will default to 5. If you want to change that, you can. Next on our tour is the output tab. This is going to allow you to configure the local DMX ports on your console. Keep in mind that this doesn't allow you to change any gateways or network-based devices, only the ones that are in your physical hardware. If you go into your remotes area, this is where you can allow or deny remotes access to the system. Keep in mind that if you're having trouble connecting your remotes, this is a good place to check. In the users area, in a multi-console system, you can now define user numbers and give them labels. Let's move over to the user area of setup. In your record defaults, you can set your tracking or queue only mode by default. You also have some update defaults, which we'll cover in more detail in a later video. In manual control, you can set some of your manual timing. This is where you can set what your level and your plus and minus percentage buttons default to. And also you can change your default times, such as sneak, your go to queue time, and your back time. And finally, moving into our device settings. In the config area, this is where you can set your device name, and this is what will show up on your network to identify that device to other systems. In face panel, you can set up some things to customize the reaction rate of your encoders and your keypad. This is also where you can enable spacebar go, which allows you to run cues from a keyboard. The next thing we want to pop into is our displays, and there are a couple of settings in here that determine how the desk will show stuff. But there are also a lot of settings in the brightness settings area, so you can set up your wings and your face panel light levels.